Namaskar children, welcome in your own channel Science Pedagogics. And here again this is your Nisha ma'am with new topic, that is solubility. So let us start with definition. Solubility is the maximum amount of solute which can be dissolved in 100 gram of solvent at given temperature to make a saturated solution. So these are the important terms of this definition. Let us try to understand. Maximum amount of solute, it means no more amount of solute can be dissolved in given amount of solvent. Okay. Second is 100 gram of solvent, amount of solvent is fixed, because as we know that if we increase the amount, solubility increases, and if we decrease the amount of solvent, solubility decreases. So we have taken a fixed amount of solvent. Next is temperature should be constant, because again solubility is directly proportional to temperature in case of solids and liquids. By increasing temperature solubility increases. अगर हम किसी भी सॉल्वेंट का टेम्परेचर इंक्रीज करेंगे तो उसकी सॉल्युबिलिटी इंक्रीज हो जाएगी. सिमिलरली बाय डिक्रीजिंग द टेम्परेचर इट डिक्रीजेस. टू मेक ए सैचुरेटेड सॉल्यूशन, दीज टू टर्म्स आर कोरिलेटेड, बिकॉज इफ नो मोर अमाउंट ऑफ सॉल्यूट इज कैन बी डिसॉल्व देन इट इज कॉल्ड एज सैचुरेटेड सॉल्यूशन. सो आई होप इट इज क्लियर दैट इट इज अमाउंट ऑफ सॉल्यूट इन 100 ग्राम ऑफ सॉल्वेंट at given temperature to make a saturated solution. The formula of solubility is solubility is equal to amount of solute in saturated solution divided by amount of solvent in saturated solution multiplied by 100. For example, 20 gram of sugar is dissolved in 50 gram of water. What is the solubility of this one? 20 gram of sugar means amount of sugar is 20 gram, which is a solute. Amount of solvent means water is 50 gram. Okay, so what is its solubility? Solubility is equal to 20 divided by 50 multiplied by 100. Amount of solute divided by amount of solvent, that is 40 gram. It means 40%, that is 40%, it indicates that 40 gram of sugar is required to make a saturated solution in water. Okay, 40%, the meaning of 40% means 40 gram of sugar is required to make a saturated solution of sugar in water. Okay, and at temperature also we need to mention temperature. Let us take the temperature to 93 Kelvin. So I hope it is clear the meaning of solubility. Now the next term is, that is percentage concentration of solution. It is the amount of solute. Okay, again we are talking about the same amount of solute, but not maximum amount that is already present. Means we are not making saturated solution, we are calculating the percentage of solution that is given to us. Present in 100 gram of solution at the given temperature. Here children, the basic difference between these two definitions, here we are comparing with amount of solvent and here we are using amount of solution, because percentage always be calculated with the whole amount. As you have already do this one, this practice while calculating your percentage in examination. Okay, for example, if you get 80 marks out of let us take 100 or 200. Okay, these are very less marks, but it's okay. 80 marks you scored out of 200, so what would be your percentage? That is 40%, that is 40%. Okay, in the same way we will take the amount of solution. Now how can we calculate the amount of solution? Again there is one more question. So amount of solution is equal to solute plus solvent. So solution is equal to solute plus solvent. Now it would be your side that you need to read the question carefully. You need to understand the language of question carefully. Why? Because you have to determine whether solution amount is given, solvent amount is given. This you can recognize only by reading of the question, only by the language of the question. So be take care about this, that whether solution is given or solvent is given. Okay, otherwise it is very simple, because this is a simple mathematical formula. Percentage concentration is equal to amount of solute divided by amount of solution multiplied by 100. Clear, children? Now next is, percentage solution can be determined by various ways. The first way is mass percentage. So we will discuss about each way with solution of some of the numericals also. Okay, so let us start with mass percentage. What do you mean by mass percentage? It is the amount of solute, okay, amount of solute dissolved in given amount of solution, okay, given amount of solution, but amount of solute and solution both are given in grams, both are given in grams as we are talking about mass. So formula of this one is equal to amount of solute in grams, okay, divided by amount of solution, because we are calculating mass percentage, means concentration in terms of mass in grams, multiplied by 100. Now let us take one example of this one. That is, if question number one, if 20 gram of sugar is dissolved in 400 gram of water. Okay, this statement is given. Calculate its mass percentage. Okay, now we need to read the language of the question. 20 gram of sugar, it means this is the mass of solute. One by one we will write the values also. Amount of solute is equal to 20 gram. Now second step, is dissolved in 400 gram of water. Now children, tell me whether water is a solvent or solution. Yes, it is a solvent. So amount of solvent, you need to read 2-3 words of question and then start writing that one related terms which is given. 400 gram in grams it is given, so there is no need to change. Now according to formula, we need to calculate amount of solution. It means solution is equal to, amount of solution is equal to 20 gram, that is solute, plus 400 gram, that is solvent, okay, which is further equal to 420 gram of solution is present. Clear? Now next step, to solve these problems, you need to write formula every time, okay? Because there is one mark for formula in your examination. Means it has a separate weightage. Percentage concentration is equal to amount of solute. I am just writing in this way. Amount of solute divided by amount of solution multiplied by 100. Okay, so formula marks we will gain by this method. Amount of solute 20 gram, now by putting the values, divided by amount of solution we have calculated, 420 multiplied by 100. Okay, that is 00 cancel out. Okay, and 100 divided by 21%. which is equal to 4 point something, that is equal to 21, which are 4 point something percent, okay? Clear? Now, this is the answer of this one. Now, just take second one. Mass percentage, but before that one, mass percentage is also be given as M by M. What is this one? M by M. M represent mass of solute, and another, the denominator M represent amount of solution. Second way to calculate mass percentage is mass by volume. Mass by volume. Okay, the formula will remain same in that one, only there is a difference, little bit difference, that is mass by volume percentage. Okay, amount of solution will be changed in milliliter. Amount of solution will be changed in milliliter. Okay, and this is also known as M by V. This is also known as M by V, means mass by volume percentage. Let us take one example of this one. Children, you need to pause the video and try to solve these examples your own, then afterwards cross check the answer. Okay, if 36 gram of sodium chloride is present in 720 ml of water. Just pay attention to the language of question. If 36 gram of sodium chloride is present in 720 ml of water, calculate mass by volume percentage of the percentage concentration of the solution. Clear? Concentration of the solution. Now, read the question. If 36 gram of NaCl, so same method, amount of solute is equal to 36 gram. Clear? In 720 ml of, is present in 720 ml of water. It means when it is the amount of solution given or amount of solvent is given? Amount of solvent is given, children. Just listen, understand the language. Present in means this much amount of sodium chloride is present in this much amount of water. So again, language of the question is little bit changed, but the sense is same. Amount of solvent is given, that is 720 ml. Okay, if I just change the language of this question, then the sense of the question changes. 36 gram of NaCl is present in 720 ml of solution. Solution made with water. Now children, the language is changed. If 36 gram of sodium chloride is present in 720 ml of solution made with water, it means now which value is given? That is value of solution is given. Value of solution is given. It means by just changing the words, by just changing the language, the sense of the question would be changed. So be careful about this one. Now, by using these values, we can calculate the percentage. Percentage concentration is equal to, now I am just putting the values direct in the formula. In this one, amount of solute 36, amount of solution 720 ml. Okay, grams is given multiplied by 100. Now, some of my students must be thinking about this one, that ma'am, here it is gram given, here it is milliliter given. How can we compare two different physical quantities? So children, just listen one thing. Density of water. What is the density of water? That is 1 gram per milliliter. Density of normal water is 1 gram per milliliter. So, the formula of density D is equal to mass upon volume. Clear? Density is given 1 gram per milliliter. Volume is given, that is 720 milliliter. Now, you can calculate the mass. M is equal to also 720 milliliter. So, this is the reason I have taken the values in the same manner. So, don't be confused. That is equal to 720 grams. Okay, I hope this is clear. Now, by solving this one, 36 ones are 36, 36 twos are 72, 20, 00 cancel out and percentage is 5%. The percentage of the solution is 5%. It means 5 gram of sugar is present in 100 gram of water. 5 gram of sugar is present in 100 gram of water, 5% m by v. Clear? Next one. One more numerical we will do with one more formula. Now the next numerical is based on the volume percent. Okay, not mass percentage, only with the volume percentage. Okay, I'll keep this one here. No, I am not able to keep this. This is, it's good. Volume percentage. Okay, it means V by V. Again, I need to change the formula. Amount of solute in milliliter. Because we are calculating V by V percentage. Okay. For example, numerical number 3. A bottle is labeled. A bottle is labeled as 95% containing sulfuric acid. Clear? You have a bottle. On that bottle, 95% labeling is given, concentration, and that bottle contains sulfuric acid in water. Now, what would be the mass of acid required to make 5 liter solution in water if 10 ml of acid present in 1 liter of water. Now children, each and every value is given in milliliter. It means it is a question related with volume by volume percentage. Clear? A bottle is labeled 95%. Percentage concentration is already given. That is 95%. Okay? H2SO4, what would be the mass of acid required to make 5 ml of solution? It means at the end, the solution must, total solution must be 5 liter. Clear? Initially what is given, that if 10 ml of acid is present in 1 liter, so what would be the mass required for this one? Just listen. If in 1 liter, okay, if in 1 liter solution, 10 ml of acid is present. Clear? So, in 5 liter solution, how much acid would be present? That is 50 ml. Clear? Direct question. 50 ml of acid would be present. This is the amount of solute, because acid is as a solute. So, we have calculated the amount of solute here. Total amount of solution is given, solute is given and percentage. We need to calculate, that is 50 ml of acid would be required to make 95% solution. 50 ml of acid would be required to make 95% of the solution. So, I hope it is clear to you. No doubt? Now children, one more question based on the solubility. That is question number 4. Let us take a different example, a little bit typical. For example, 20 gram of sodium chloride and 10 gram of sugar dissolved in 200 ml of water, milliliter of water. Clear? This statement is given. If 20 gram of sodium chloride and 10 gram of sugar dissolved in 200 milliliter of water, calculate percentage concentration of sugar and NaCl means salt. There are two different solute are present in same solvent. Again, sodium chloride and sugar, these two are solvent. So S1 solute 1 is equal to 20 gram, that is sodium chloride. Solute 2, that is sugar, is equal to 10 gram. Okay, now next is amount of solution. Amount of solution is equal to solute 1 S1 plus S2 plus water, that is solvent. 200 means amount of solvent. Clear? Now by putting the values, S1 is equal to 20, S2 is equal to 10 plus that is equals to 200. 230. That is amount of solution is 230 grams. We can take it as a gram also. Percentage concentration. Percentage concentration of sodium chloride. By putting the values in the same formula, that is solute upon solution. Now here the solute is 20 divided by 230 multiplied by 100. Percentage we are calculating, so we will use this one. That is 0 to 0 cancel out. 2 upon 200 divided by 23%. Children, you will calculate in fraction. Clear? Now, percentage concentration of sugar. Amount of sugar is 10 gram. So, by putting the values in the same formula, 10 divided by 230 multiplied by 100, that is equal to 100 divided by 23%. So this is the way to calculate the percentage concentration of a given